In this presentation, we will learn a new operator called value of operator, which is very useful for us in order to understand the concepts of pointers. So let's get started. Value of operator or indirection operator or dereference operator is an operator that is used to access the value stored at the location pointed by the pointer. If I want to access the value stored at the location pointed by the pointer, then I can use this value of operator. Let me show how this operator works. Suppose I have a variable x which stores value 5, and here is the pictorial representation of this variable x. Apart from this, I have a pointer which simply points to some integer value which is indicated by this data type, and here is the pictorial representation of pointer. And with the help of this statement, I am simply assigning the address of this variable x to this pointer variable. We can see here the address of variable x is 1000, therefore 1000 will get stored inside this pointer variable. It simply means that now this pointer can point to variable x, right? Now, with the help of this printf function, what I am trying to do is, I am trying to print this value 5 on the screen. How? With the help of this star operator, which is also called as value of operator. It will simply take whatever is stored in the object. Here in this case, the object is this variable x, and we can see the stored value in this variable is 5. Therefore, with the help of the star operator, I can take this value, and with the help of this printf function, I can print this value on the screen. Therefore, the output is 5. We can also change the value of the object pointed by the pointer. Not only we can access the value of the object pointed by the pointer, we can also change the value of the object which is pointed by the pointer. For example, suppose we have this variable x which contains value 10, and we have this pointer variable which simply points to this variable x. And here is the pictorial representation in which this pointer ptr is pointing to variable x. Now, with the help of this statement, I can go inside this variable x and can change this value 10 to value 4. What this statement says is, by simply writing ptr, I can access the content of this ptr, that is 1000. And with the help of this dereference operator or indirection operator or value of operator, I can simply go to this particular location and can access this value. After accessing this value with the help of this assignment statement, I can also change this value. Now the variable x contains value 4 after this assignment, right? Then I can simply print this value on the screen. So the output of this program is 4, right? There is a word of caution for you. Never apply the indirection operator to the uninitialized pointer. This is very important for us to understand. We should never apply the indirection operator to the uninitialized pointer. It is very important for us to initialize the pointer before applying the indirection operator. For example, if we try to do something like this, then it is totally illegal. Here you are trying to access the content stored at the location which is pointed by the PTR. But please note down that here you are not initializing this pointer variable. This pointer must have to point to some location before applying the dereference operator. But here we can see we are not initializing this pointer, and we are simply applying this dereference operator. We can't do this, okay? If we do this, then we can observe some undefined behavior. Also, assigning value to an uninitialized pointer is dangerous. For example, here we can see that this pointer is uninitialized. We applied the dereference operator, and not only we are applying the dereference operator, we are also trying to assign the value to the object which is pointed by this pointer. But please note down that this pointer is not pointing to any location, right? It is important to first initialize this pointer before accessing the content of the location pointed by the pointer. It will produce the segmentation fault error. You can easily see here that this pointer is not pointing to any location. So how we can go to that location and provide this value to the location? It will produce the segmentation fault error. Let me briefly describe what the segmentation fault error means. Usually, segmentation fault is caused by the program trying to read or write an illegal memory location. Here we can see that we are applying the dereference operator to the pointer which is not pointing to any location. Internally, it may point to some location which is illegal memory location. We, the user, have no rights to access the location. Therefore, it may produce the segmentation fault error. Okay, friends, this is it for now. Thank you for watching this presentation.